Infections caused by microbes like fungus, bacteria, and viruses have plagued humans for centuries. We now have life-saving vaccines that have eradicated diseases like smallpox and have drastically reduced cases of polio and measles. But what are vaccines? How do they work? And why are they important for public health? Hi, I'm Timothy Sheahan, and welcome to a journey through the fascinating history and critical importance of vaccination. From ancient practices to today's cutting-edge technology, vaccines have played a pivotal role in shaping global public health here. We're going to take a brief look at the history of vaccines and ultimately answer, how do vaccines work, and why are they important for public health? The history of vaccines begins in the 10th century China, where early attempts at smallpox prevention involved a practice called variolation. In this case, scabs were taken from the skin of smallpox victims. Then they were dried and ground and inhaled. Fast forward to the 18th century, when Lady Mary Wortley Montagu, an English aristocrat, introduced variolation to Europe after witnessing its success in the Ottoman Empire. Enter Edward Jenner, an English physician who revolutionized vaccination in 1796 by using cowpox to protect against smallpox. This marked the birth of the term vaccination. Throughout the 19th and 20th centuries, the smallpox vaccine gained global acceptance, leading to a successful eradication campaign in the 20th century. Meanwhile, Louis Pasteur's groundbreaking work in 1885 brought us the rabies vaccine, a major step forward in preventing deadly diseases.
The mid-20th century ushered in the golden age of vaccines, with Jonas Salk's inactivated polio vaccine making waves in 1955, followed by Albert Sabin's oral polio vaccine.
In the 1960s, the development and widespread adoption of the MMR vaccine provided combined protection against measles, mumps, and rubella in a single inoculation. This trivalent vaccine significantly contributed to the decline of these highly contagious infections and played a pivotal role in the success of childhood vaccination programs worldwide. The 1980s saw the advent of the hepatitis B vaccine, a pioneer in recombinant DNA technology, paving the way for future vaccine developments. In 2006, the HPV vaccine emerged as a powerful tool against cervical cancer, showcasing the power of vaccination in the prevention of cancer. Fast forward to 2020, when the rapid development of COVID-19 vaccines, particularly those utilizing mRNA technology, marked a historic achievement in the face of a global pandemic.
Now that you know a little bit about the history, let's talk about how they're developed and how they work.
Infections with microbes like bacteria, virus, and fungi can lead to serious disease and even death. But humans have evolved a very powerful system that reacts when microbes invade our body called the immune system. The fascinating thing about the immune system is that it has a memory. It remembers how microbes look and is poised to attack if reinfected. The immune system is a complex and highly coordinated system with many kinds of specialized cells, which perform different functions, much like factory workers on an assembly line. Two key kinds of cells are T cells, which can directly kill infected cells, and B cells, which make antibodies that can soak up microbes like a sponge. Vaccination simply harnesses this natural process, allowing us to build up specific immunity to invading microbes before we get infected. Since infections can be transmitted from person to person and can spread rapidly in communities, vaccines not only prevent disease on an individual level, but also stop the chain of transmission in the community. In this way, vaccination is a way to protect yourself, your loved ones around you, and people you may not have even met. Challenges persist. Despite the life-saving wonders of vaccines, too many people remain unvaccinated. From ethical dilemmas to unequal access worldwide, a lot is holding us back. As we move forward, the focus is on global health equity, ensuring everyone everywhere has a shot at protection. Remember, vaccines have come a long way since the 10th century, but our quest for global well-being is far from over. Stay informed, stay healthy. Thank you.